My name is Tracy Dreyer, and I'm the scientific glassblower here for the chemistry department. The reason the lab is here is to provide support for all of the research that gets done in the rest of the building. Yeah, there's some seriously interesting work going on in this department all the time. The work that the professors do, I mean, I just support them.
So for example, fuel cells essentially do oxygen chemistry at one of the electrodes. And so fuel cells for the production of electricity. We've been designing new glassware to allow us to study the catalysts that are operating in these fuel cells. You just start to describe it to him, you kind of explain to him kind of the function, and then it just somehow magically appears, you know, after he does his craft in the laboratory, in the glass lab. And this interchange of ideas with Tracy has really been an enabling tool for us in our research.
Right now, I have a class going on to learn some of the basic techniques of scientific glassblowing.
We all use glassware so ubiquitously in everything that we do. You know, even simply running gas to your reaction, you need to have some sort of piece of glassware that mediates that interface. And so being able to build these our own manifolds or whatnot has been really an interesting process to learn.
Not every university or chemistry department has a glass blower. And so to have the skills to make small repairs or build some of your own instruments is very valuable.
Kind of throughout my time here, I've been using glassware in various ways, and I've broken glassware in various ways. And so ultimately, I know I can bring it to Tracy, and he'll fix it. And so having the opportunity to learn how he does that, how do you repair glass, how do you fix these kind of things really interested me. Kind of the rough idea of what's feasible, what's not, you know, what's easy, what's not, things like that.
So learning these kind of skills would be really helpful for any future career, especially if I want to have my own small research laboratory.
As I heat glass, it tends to constrict, and so by having this blow hose, I'm able to either maintain the shape or I'll be able to blow holes in where necessary.
And it allows you to basically innovate on the job. And so, you know, when you have to schedule innovation, it's not quite as effective. And so to have this kind of daily access to someone with whom you can consult about your research and the design of the equipment that you need, it really facilitates the whole process.
One of the unfortunate things about glass is that it breaks. This is an $800 bill. Buying something like this for a half hour of my time, we can have this as good as new. You know, they're young researchers and they're trying to learn new things. Well, let's see. And if I can help them, I'd love that. And then this would go inside of a fume hood. It's ready to go. You know, there's so much energy in the department, and they're all trying their hardest to push the boundaries, and to be able to help them is wonderful.